Hey, you guys, it is Jim. So for those that have seen West Side Story, you'll recognize this handsome devil. That's Bernardo, a.k.a. Alex Aguilar. And, dude, congratulations, man.
Thanks, man.
It's absolutely, positively an amazing show, and you're phenomenal.
Thank you. I appreciate that. It's really nice.
I got to tell you that just watching everything that you guys got to do of the just the physical nature of the fight scenes, the singing, the dancing.
Yeah.
It's got to be exhausting after doing just one performance, much more two performances a night.
Yeah, it's tough.
And mentally and emotionally, it's got to be exhausting.
Yeah,
right?
It's a really intense show. It's really like, you know, the stakes are really high. You know, there's some shows that you do that are a little easier because, you know, the story's maybe a little bit lighter. This one's really heavy, you know,
right.
And if you don't really bring it, if you don't really bring that kind of emotion, the whole show kind of suffers. So you kind of have to give it your all every time. But yeah, it's exhausting, but it's fun. You know, it's good.
So we were talking off camera, and, you know, I saw it originally that you were from Oswego, but really, you're originally these all started here in Aurora,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. My first house was over on South Avenue in Aurora. Yeah, you could jog here. You could jog to my original house from here. And I used to do children's theater at they call it the Copley Center now. It used to be the North Island Center. I used to do children's theater with my brother at Laughing Rainbow Theater, and that's kind of where it all started, was out here. So.
And I should say your brother, Adrian,
yeah.
has been with us. He was in here, and he was in Greece with
us. Yes, he was. Yeah. I came and saw him play Burger and Hare here right when they first started doing the Broadway series.
Yeah.
It was awesome, and from that moment on, I was like, all right, I can't wait to work here. It's going to be great, yeah.
So you moved to Oswego, and what comes first? Is it dancing? Is it singing? Is it acting? Was it kind of the perfect storm? You decided you fell in love with all three?
Yeah, it was kind of everything. Well, I started doing musicals. My brother and I were doing them when we were little kids, like summer camps and stuff. But the biggest thing for me was that I'm a huge Michael Jackson fan.
Oh yeah.
So like when I was a little kid, I wanted to learn all the moves, I wanted to learn all the dancing, and I got really into break dancing and the popping and locking. I got like super, super into that. And then that kind of went hand in hand with doing theater, and it kind of helped me in that direction. And then when I was in high school, I knew that I really wanted to take it seriously, so I transferred to the Chicago Academy for the Arts and started training there really seriously at that point.
So people understand what that is. It's really kind of the fame school here in Chicago.
Yeah, yeah, it's an art high school. I call it the Island of Misfit Toys. It's a beautiful, beautiful place. I love it. I got to be a musical theater major there, so I would take the train every day out to the city, and we'd do our academics till about like 1:30 in the afternoon, and then we'd get a small break, and then from the rest of the afternoon and the evening, I was taking, you know, ballet, voice lessons, acting classes, working on shows, working on reviews, and sort of training more seriously than you would probably at most other high schools, you know.
And then, correct me if I'm wrong, you went out to Ohio to go to college?
Yeah,
right?
I went to the Cincinnati Conservatory out there. It was the only school that I wanted to go to. And
why is that?
Well, I started working at the Wagon Wheel Theater when I was in high school with my brother.
Yeah.
We started doing stock out there, summer stock. And when I got out there, I didn't really know much about college or, you know, where was good or where I should go. And I started asking around there. I said, you know, where's the best place to go? Where's a place? I said, where would I go if I wanted to take it very, very seriously? You know, if I wanted to do this as a profession. And almost every single person said, well, CCM is a really tough school. It's really, you know, they're really hard on their kids there. And they're really adamant about you becoming a professional. And so I said, all right, cool, I'll go there. And I went there, went to Ohio, auditioned, and went there for 4 years and graduated. So.
And pretty much, you go from Ohio and then you decide, I'm going to go to New York. Right?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
You took that big leap right out of the gate.
Yeah, I started working kind of out here in Chicago during college at the Marriott. And right when I graduated, I did some shows. I did some shows at Ravinia and at Marriott. And after I finished up those contracts at Marriott, I moved right out in 2010 to New York. So I've been there ever since.
And it's worked quite nicely. You've been on Broadway?
Yeah, yeah.
So you want to talk a little bit about the show you did?
Yeah, it's crazy. I was in a show called Liz Estrada Jones that was on Broadway. I got the show, and it all happened really, really fast. Did the show on Broadway and got to do some really cool stuff. I'm on the cast recording and all that. And then... That show kind of closed in sort of a unexpected way, and I was sort of lost for a few weeks, and then I got a call about doing the national tour of Memphis, the musical. So then I jumped on that for about a year and started doing that.
And just so people understand, people think like, man, you go to Broadway, like, you know, as far as the show's concerned, it's set, it's going to run forever. It's really competitive.
Oh, yeah.
Hard to even launch a show on Broadway.
Sure.
And there's shows that just come and go, like, you know, after all the time.
Yeah.
It may be up for a little bit and then it goes away. They got another show to fill in.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
you as an actor, it's time to literally go, even though you've been doing a show on Broadway, time to go find more ways to pay the bill, right?
Yeah, you're really never finished, you know, because the business is so unpredictable and shows can open and shows can close. And, you know, there's shows that say they're going to open, they don't. There's some that are unexpected hits. And as a performer, you just have to be game for whatever, you know, and you have to be game to take jobs anywhere in the country, anywhere in the world, really. You know, I've sung on cruise ships across the other side of the world, and you know, anywhere that there's work, you have to kind of be game to kind of pick up and go. So
yeah, and I think that's like one of the overriding things we hear from actors all the time. We were talking to Joe Dempsey earlier about man, when he was starting and he was an improviser, you play in a 25 seat black box that you produced yourself and you're handing out flyers to get people to come.
Sure.
But it's all part of what you do as your trade to get to you know, whatever the next level is going to be for you.
Yeah, you know, you gotta there's a lot of adult things that you don't think about when you're a kid, like getting your insurance, which is, you know, you have to work as an actor. You have to work a lot of weeks to get your insurance, and you have to pay your bills, and it really is a job. It's a job. It just so happens to be that we love what we do, and it's exciting, and it's very cool, but it's still a job. You still got to, like, work for it. You know?
Right.
So, yeah.
Well, look, you're amazing at your job.
Thank you.
We couldn't be more thrilled to have you here.
Man.
And we're going to let you go because you got another show to do tonight.
Sure do, yeah.
But thank you for taking the time.
Of
thank
course.
You for the amazing performance that you're putting
thank
on
you so
up
much.
There. Everybody loves you and the critics and the audiences.
So
come see Alex as Bernardo, man, and his castmates. Absolutely phenomenal. And nothing but a pleasure to get to talk to you, man.
Thank
Thanks
you, brother,
for taking
you
the
well.
Time.
Appreciate it.